All right. I know, Tatsat. I just sent a gnat back to its source. So it didn't have to live a 24-hour gnat life. Should be thankful. Greetings, all. I hope everyone's feeling very content. Here we are in the greatest magic trick under the sun. You exist as this character in the most miraculous magic trick under the sun, including the sun. All part of a story, an immaculate story, absolutely nothing wrong with it. The story immaculate, like the Immaculate Conception. It's like that. It's like the Immaculate, exactly, that's what is the Immaculate Conception, is creation. Why? Because it's untouched. It just happens spontaneously from nothing. Everything, actually. But what we would call no thing, self, or Atma, just like that makes a universe. Pretty amazing stuff. Amazing stuff. Immaculate, untouched. When one finds one's true self, true nature, which is very easy to do. Only the mind makes it difficult. That's no problem. So, on finding your true nature, natural state, you see the immaculate. You see the immaculate. All old things become very new again. Not to you, the character is still there, the imprint. But you realize, awakening is realizing the one who's living the life. The one. I'm not, the last few weeks I've broken this down enough. So everyone knows, we're starting from zero. Everyone here knows you don't know anything, okay? Whatever your mind says, I know, forget it, it's not true. We already did that. I'm not going to do that each week. I feel like I'm coming down with a hammer on all of you. And I want to give you a break. So now I want to show you, okay, so if there's nothing here, it's not nihilism. I'll tell you that. It's not meaningless. Only an ego would make that statement. Upon knowing true self, it has full meaning. It's overspilling with me. True love. Original romance. Between para atma and atma. Shiva Shakti, the energy, consciousness, the elements, the molecules. You're sitting in a soup of molecules right now. This is a fact. It's so funny to watch people. They'll watch a science show where they're told this, and then they'll go doodly-doo back to, I don't like this one. It's separating everything when they were just told it's just molecules moving around. Whose molecules? They belong to nature. The ego would say, really? So that's the pivotal point. That's man's downfall. the fall of man is he imagined himself outside of nature, God. And that imagination has paid off very well, don't you think? Anxiety, paranoia, greed, all come from that first fall. Maharaj used to say, what a fall. Yeah? But now, what I want to do is bring everyone around to what arise, what a return. Forget the fall. Now you know we brought it to zero. You can do that on your own now. You don't need me to keep bringing it to zero. So the fall was everything within the play has its place, but man with this higher psychic instrument, which has the quality of knowing itself, as I've said, this principle consciousness can know itself. It got waylaid, it identified with something very small, the body, and then it got lost in symbols, alphabet, concept, thinking stuff. And then it came up with the idea, I can do it better. I can make sure tomorrow's gonna be safe. And it's never seen tomorrow, so it's really a troubling task. And it creates anxiety for the molecules. Bring it down to that level. There's just molecules here. There's no people. I'm speaking to the molecules. That's what you are. Your body is molecules. It's a soup. This empty stuff, it's not empty. That's not philosophy. That's not imagination. That's not, that's a fact. We don't know what it is, though. We don't know what a molecule is, that's zero. So now you're at zero. Everyone here, you know nothing. You don't know who you are or what anything is. But what do you know, everyone here? You know that you are. You just don't know what you are, but you can damn well say, I am. Every one of you. So what is that I am? If it's not the somebody, if it's not the information which is erroneous, it's pure awareness right now. But whose is it if it's not yours? This is what you want to find out without the you. It's not a gaining. The ego and its anxiety creates all these false divides in the molecules, in the soup of nothingness, dancing, loving itself. Flowers in the meadow aren't fighting. I never saw a bunch of dandelions having an army against the daffodils. You just don't see that in nature. But how did we get outside of nature? Well, hold on a minute. All of us here came from a single cell in this play of molecules, a single cell. What was your name? Did you know your name when you were a single cell? Where did that cell grow? Maharaj used to say, sometimes, I have a very interesting question. When you were conceived, did your father push you into the womb or your mother pull you into the womb? Because you're identified with the body, yeah? Everyone here, I have a body, you're saying. Well, who has the body? Not the thought. not the conscious thought, the mind saying, I'm the body. That's a thought believing a thought. And no one here, no one can possibly tell me what a thought is or where it comes from. Or the next one you'll have, apparently. Zero. It's fine at zero. That's beingness. Without mind movement. The highest teaching is no. No isms, no alphabet, no symbols, no isms, no baptisms, no anything. We've gone through this for weeks now. You can do this on your own all the time. We are like grass growing. We are as natural to this soup of molecules called the waking state in life, or enlivened self. That's why desire itself comes out of fear. That's why all these desires never will reach. You already have what you're seeking, because you're seeking yourself, this ennui, something's wrong. Something gnawing is inside. You get four yachts, it's not enough. You know, come on. Five houses, you can only sleep in one bed. This is the outcome of fear for being outside of nature, the fall of man. Garden of Eden, everything was fine. We ate from the tree of false knowledge. Who's we? We are that which is comes from the absolute. Just self. I don't have to do anything. No, you don't. You just have to recognize what I'm saying. Another page in the story of the Immaculate. What you want to do is listen to what I'm saying, throw it out, let this just come forward. No resistance. Stop it. And you will see the Immaculate of which I speak. You will never need another thing because you will be gone. This false idea will disappear. And in its place will be universal knowing. The one who's really here, the real you. This is good news. Come on, somebody smile. This is good damn news here. This is what I always laugh about. I get it. But the egoic structure says, wait a minute. And then it's almost like, I don't know if I want to do that. Really? You want to be real. You want to be this suffering one. That's false. Come on. You don't. And I'm speaking to someone who's not. So, but what you really are wants to be free, because it is freedom. Your freedom now. When is the next golden age? You know, we were talking about yugas and stuff and cosmology. Now, I said that last time. I said that the first one, the ego thinks, oh, it was better then. No, the golden age is returning to yourself. There's nothing more heady, nothing more absolutely transformative than self remembering self, which is what we call enlightenment. The forgetting began when, with the fall of mankind, we are just part of the holonomic flow of mankind. If everyone here believes they've had other lives, let's say you've had 100 of them, which one is you? You've been man, child, old man, woman, old woman, all these iterations of this same suit. Which one are you out of all those iterations? So now, this is the good part. Now, in this dream, as we speak, the words are going into the little bony bones made of molecules in your eerie ears and saying doodly doo. And so, hello, you've heard the message. Maharaj used to say, now you know the nothing, now you can go. I'm not throwing anyone out, but what I'm saying is the message has been delivered. The process has begun. Everyone here has been coming for a while. There's lately a lot of new people watching these vids, but I don't think they realize that I'm speaking to a group that I've been seeing for a while, you know, that there's a connect, that I'm, you know, if I bark, it's because I know you now, and I stop, you know, this kind of thing. Everything's so PC these days. In the dream. Everybody's so nervous. Did you ever see a nervous rose? Did you ever see a rose filled with anxiety? No. No, you haven't. I wanted to read two things today from Krishnamurti. Again, emphasizing now what I've said is we broke everything down to zero. So now you know you don't know anything. It's simple. You don't know anything. Accept it. Now we're going to build up to what is. We're not even going to build up. It's there. It's not meaningless. The one that's living this loves it. It's effulgent. Well, it's effulgent and effulgent, and it's fragrant, and it's perfect. It's immaculate. Only the one who says, I'm outside of nature, not knowing how you got here. Come on. You were a single cell, which is empty. That's how you got here. Two people were having fun in a dreamy space, and now there's more fun for you. Before all the isms and all the symbols and all the downloaded information, when you were 1.5, what was your opinion of the sun? What did you think of the problems of the earth? When was the first time you even heard that there's a thing called the earth? You were already here. I guess you were stupid. No, you weren't. Then you were pristine, immaculate. Natural. The holonomic flow is repeating the fall of man. We are just bubbles in it. Each life is just an imagination, really. But when you know the one that's dreaming this, it's everything. It's so solid. It's so, when I say the ego has no support, like this idea of you and the parents and the dream has no support. That which is really dreaming is the ultimate support of all things. I am the original one. Mayor Baba went around saying that like he was God or something, like he was the only one who was the original one. That's not true. Would you, you know, so everyone worship Mayor Baba. Worship your own self. God dwells within you as you right now. Right, Ollie? Yeah. This is Krishnamurti. Up there in the shade, it was cool and fresh and beautiful. The mountains and the hills, the valleys and the shadows. The land was boggy in places. And there grew reeds, short and golden colored. And among the gold were white flowers. But this was not all. Going up and down, there was during that whole hour and a half, that strength, which is a benediction. It has the quality of enormous and impenetrable solidity. No matter could have, possibly, that solidity. Matter is penetrable, keeps moving. What we call matter is empty. Matter is penetrable, can be broken down, dissolved, vaporized. Thought and feeling have a certain weight. They can be measured, and they too can be changed, destroyed, and nothing left of them. But this strength, which nothing can penetrate nor dissolve, was not the projection of thought and certainly not matter. This strength was not an illusion. This strength was not an illusion, a creation of a brain that was secret. This strength was not an illusion, a creation of a brain that was secretly seeking power, or that strength that power gives, the fall of man. No brain can formulate such strength with its strange intensity and solidity. It was there, and no thought could invent it or dispel it. There comes an intensity when there is no need for anything. Natural. Food, clothes, and shelter are necessities, and they are not needs. The ego says, I need to get them, but does the flower need to go to the store? I promise you, when self comes into your, when you give up this dance of being separate, everything will be there that you need. Necessities will be there. And then you'll be overspilling with goldenness. There comes an intensity when there is no need for anything. Food, clothes, and shelter are necessities, and they are not needs. The need is the hidden craving, which makes for attachment. The need for sex, for drinking, for fame, for worship, with their complex causes. The need for self-fulfillment, with its ambitions and frustrations. The need for God, for immortality. When you are, all these forms of need inevitably breed that attachment which causes sorrow, fear, and the ache of loneliness. The need to express oneself through music, though writing or through painting or through some other means, makes for a desperate attachment to means. A musician who uses his instrument to achieve fame, to become the best, ceases to be a musician. He does not love music, but the profits of music. We use each other in our needs and call it by sweet-sounding names. The fall of man. Now we're using each other instead of just flowing with each other, loving. And we call it by sweet-sounding names. Out of this grows despair and unending sorrow. We use God as a refuge, as a protection, like some medicine. And so the church, the temple, with its priests become very significant when they have no significance. We use everything, machines, techniques, for our psychological needs, and there is no love for the thing itself. There is love only when there is no need. The essence of the self is this need, and the content, the essence of the self is this need and the constant change of needs and the everlasting search from one attachment to another, from one temple to another, from one commitment to another, to commit oneself to an idea, to a formula, to belong to something, to become sect or dogma, is the drive of need, the essence of the self, small self, ego, which takes the form of the most altruistic activities. It's a cloak, a mask. The freedom from need is maturity. With this freedom comes intensity, shakti, which has no cause nor profit. Not bad for a beginner, huh? This is the no loss, no gain. Where is that? Right here now. Every moment you spend away from it is a moment you, the false one, spends away from what I just said. Now that one's gonna go, well, I don't think I feel it the way you do. Well, it might take a little time, okay? But you know where to begin. From zero, from no. When? Constantly. Mindful. Be mindful. Mindful to you. This, who's doing this living? You want to know. Who's doing this apparent dying? You want to know. Yeah? Anandamayi Ma once said, this fall of mankind that I'm referencing has created the greatest fear, and it's around the neck of humanity is the fear of death. All the other things in nature don't fear death. They protect the body, but they go to death sweetly because there's no death. Creation, emptiness is form, form is emptiness, remember. This is just a holographic dream of life. That solidness, that self, can cut diamonds like butter, to quote Maharaj. I say it eats them for breakfast. Same difference, right? What you are is real. This sense of I am is real. I first wanted to bring everyone to the point of saying, I don't get it. You have to start from zero. Any of these isms and systems and symbols keep that mentation in swing. I say get rid of it. You didn't have it when you came in, you're not going to take it with you. Why do you carry it around? Your opportunity is now. It's okay. This is the good news. This is the good news. You're missing out. It's like there's a big party of the I'll make you feel bad. There's a big party going on and everyone's having a blast and you're not invited. Rats. Well, you don't have to be. You are invited. Come home. Come home. It's okay. Everything's all right. All right. Immaculate. Golden age is now. This is your time to be golden. With forgetfulness comes remembrance. This is the time of remembrance. In the dream of life, that's safe. So safe, so absolutely safe anyway. And then finding this that is. All of life is just this complete allowing of the death of the last moment and embracing the birth of the next. Even though it's a dream, it's your dream. So now you can really love, you can really be fully unafraid. Yeah, the last moment's gone, but look at the next. And then after that, this you don't die. The body's just empty. You're not the body. You're formal serenity right now. got on this ride and got a little lost, that's all. The soul ride. The ride of the soul. The ray of the absolute. And once it's done, it's done. It's that's it. I mean, there's no one left to argue. That one's been seen for what it is. Now it's full. Really full. Unbelievable. Completely supported. Not chasing the next thing to make you feel a little better and always, that wasn't it. You're looking, it's like, what's the old expression? The guy looking for something with a flashlight, and he's looking in the light, but he's not looking back. He's looking out here in the light, in the show, not knowing it's, where am I? Yeah. You're the flashlight in that analogy. But that flashlight is space-like, it's permanent. It has no beginning and end. Right now, no beginning and end. Those are ideas. You're prior to all ideas. Don't let the dream tug you. That's my advice. Keep going back to zero. No matter what the sitch, whatever sitch comes up, back to zero. The emotions run hot, back to zero. They're not yours, they're just emotion. Matter of fact, when all is said and done, the emotions and all become yours as that which is owns them. Not this interloper who's really, he likes this but doesn't like that. She likes that, but I don't, not so much, ah. Did you ever see a daisy complain in a meadow? Did you ever see a birch tree? Did a birch tree ever, when you're passing it, go, come here. You see that oak? I don't like him. Watch out. He's a rascal. All that rascalness came out of imagining of the consciousness, not of you, not of you, of the consciousness that it's the body separate and afraid. So it has to do things to be safe. And what do we end up with? A bunch of nuclear weapons, just in case. Is that funny or what? It is, believe me. It's very funny because that's the result of ignorance. The fall of man. Not only is everybody you, it's molecules, fundamentally. It's one substance, it's one stuffy stuff. And we have all these measures, all these committee ideas. You don't have to be concerned with that. That the flow of this whole thing has nothing to do with you. You're here to know who you are. And that's helping the flow. If there's any altruistic urge that I should help this situation, that's your best bet. Find out who you are. Any help you try to deliver in the meantime is at best, it's a band-aid, it's fine. Be nice, play nice. But once you know what is, that's the greatest help because it spreads. into the space. But remember one thing, it never happened. None of this ever happened. I'll end with this. This is the other thing I marked last week, actually. Oh yeah, this is Maharaj, who was an expression in consciousness that spoke truth. Maharaj, he says, this is Maharaj speaking, the ultimate state is that state in which nothing exists, neither I nor you, nor manifestation, prior to consciousness. Questioner, can Maharaj describe the ultimate state, right? People have asked me to do this, and it's, can't be done. He said, can I cut up my sleep and make a design out of it? My sleep state, can I cut it up and make a design out of it? Disassociate yourself from your body and tell me something about that. In other words, if you're not the body, now tell me what you are. That's the hypnosis of the consciousness, not of you. You is a pronoun, it's a symbol, it's a word you didn't have when you were one and a half or a single cell. As long as we're being identified with something rather than everything. Yeah? The one who identifies with the body is the consciousness itself. It mistakenly assumes that it is the body and behaves as if it is behaves as if its unlimited potential, your potential, has been limited by this one single phenomenon, a body. I just told you it's a soup, so the space is no different than the edge of your skin that you're identified with, Mr. Consciousness and Mrs. Consciousness, which is no Mr. and Mrs. So where does the body begin and where does this body begin and end? Not with the air, which you call the air. It mistakenly assumes that the body, that it is the body and behaves as if its unlimited potential has been limited by this one single phenomenon, this mistake. Therefore, with this identification, behavior, whatever behavior the consciousness adopts will be limited to the body. Me, everything else, not in nature anymore. Let's make sure we're safe. Let's get those ones we don't like. I don't trust that one over there. He has more than us. Uh-oh, let's go get it. Let's fulfill every desire because we feel lost because we are. This ennui, this gnawing feeling like something's wrong. So the attention goes out, we'll do this, we'll try. Anxiety. The one who understands this ultimate meaning of life gets disassociated from the body and a transformation takes place. Very much so. The consciousness is universal, universal like the day, universal like the night. To that principle, you cannot give a name or a title. The desire to be free is, the questioner says, is the desire to be free wrong? Maharaj says, there is nothing happening. Nobody is bound. Therefore, there is no question of liberation. There is nothing happening. nobody is bound. Therefore, there is no question of liberation. I always say enlightenment is no accomplishment, because there's no one to accomplish it. It's a transition. But when you see these people being fancy, their transition's not so complete. That's it. You can start that. Whatever concepts you have collected in this world are totally useless. I've said this for a while now. Well, everything you know, could know, possibly ever collect knowledge-wise adds up to zero. Back to zero. Understand that the total manifestation is the child of a barren woman. Time, the universe, came from nothing. Is that not magical enough? We're peering into what we call matter, saying, we don't know what's there, but we act like we do. The ego is like, when all is so natural and very revealing from that natural state, you know exactly what it is as that. It can never be articulated because those are symbols. Symbols are symbols. They're not the map is not the terrain. I could show you a map, but if we go into the forest, it's not going to look like the map. Language is a map. So I'm trying to use a map to show you. That's why they call it pointers. To nobody. From nobody, in eternity. Now, I don't experience, I know time is happening, what we call time, but I'm not in time. There's no time here. The natural state is your eternal state. No death, no birth, dream, enjoy. You mean I don't have to suffer? No, that's the last thing you have to do, is suffer. No. If you want to suit yourself, your erroneous self, but I wouldn't recommend it. He ends with, take good care of this work that you do in the world, because it's an orphan. The world itself has, it came from nothing. It's really not happening. It's just an appearance. From the point of view of the self, it's just this lovely dance with itself. The original romance that I go on about. Yeah? It's yours. Right now. And that, I think I'll make some rice and veggies, brown rice and veggies and blueberries. Life is good. Life is groovy. I have my little toy, my spinny toy. What else do I need? I can go like this. Be endlessly amused. All right. I'd like to say thank you all for
coming
and sharing.
Thank you.
Power your own touch. Lots of love. And see you next time. Be happy, please.